Hey everyone, this video is about the Flipper Zero with the ESP32 module. In this video, we're going to use Marauder to do a Rickroll attack, a deauth attack, and transmit a secret message using SSIDs. I'm using the Dolphin board and the ESP32 that comes with the Dolphin kit. I'll put a link in the comments. If you just want to see the secret message SSID script, jump ahead to 3 minutes and 16 seconds. Let's get started. My ESP32 is already flashed with Marauder. You can see my GitHub for directions on how to do that. The ESP32 enables 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi features for your Flipper Zero. Go into Applications, GPIO, and then we'll go down to ESP32 Wi-Fi Marauder. We're going to choose Scan Access Point. Once that runs for a while, we're going to press the back button, and then we'll choose Scan Station. And we'll let that run for a while. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to show and not show, because I'm still learning about Wi-Fi, so I'm just blurring this video. And after that's run for a while, we'll go down to List, and then choose Station. TP-Link access point is 21, my computer's Station 19, starting with 70. So we'll go select that access point of 21. So go ahead and type in 21 here. And then we'll press back a couple of times and then we'll select station. And this time the number is 19. Now that we've selected both the station and the access point, we can go ahead and go back and do an attack. We'll do the deauth attack. So you can see my PC is just pinging Cloudflare at 1111. Now we're running the attack. And you can see now we're getting a request timeout because I'm disconnected from the internet. Okay, we're gonna hit back. You can see the network starting to start up again. There we are, we're back on, we're able to see 1111. Do the attack again. And there you go, it's disconnected. So that's pretty awesome. So again, that's the ESP32 doing 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi devices that you can attack. Make sure you're only attacking your own devices by selecting the station IDs. My neighbors are probably tired of this one, but we're gonna demo the Rickroll attack next. And what this does is, there we go, we're running the attack. And unfortunately, you can't isolate this just to your own devices. Everybody's gonna pick this up. So over on my PC and on my neighbor's PC, they're gonna see these Wi-Fis with the lyrics to Never Gonna Give You Up. So the Rickroll inspired me to create the Secret SSID project, which I'll show next. In Visual Studio Code, we right-click on Encode, say Open an Integrated Terminal, and then we'll type in encode.ps1. Next, we'll type in the mobile phone number for the A-Team, 555-6162, and we get back a bunch of SSIDs we can use. Next, we'll go ahead and try that encode again. This time, we'll just type in hello. It encodes our hello into hex, and then encodes that hex to give us a bunch of SSIDs we can use. Each of these SSIDs decode to the same message. This time, we'll use the phone number 555-2368. And we get AL6FVOPR. Our friend in the coffee shop is going to right click on scan, open an integrated terminal, and then they're going to run scan PS1. This is going to periodically scan for access points and then try to decrypt them for secret messages. So our friend's running that script on their laptop. Meanwhile, on our flipper, we're going to open Wi-Fi Marauder. We'll go down to SSID, and instead of add random, we're going to say add name. We can choose any one of the SSIDs that the encoding tool gave us. So for this example, we'll just go ahead and choose that first SSID that we had, which was the AL6FVOPR. Go ahead and hit save and then go back a couple times. Now we'll go down to list SSID and make sure it's in the list. It is, okay, back. And then we'll go down to the beacon spam and we'll say SSID list. So go ahead and press OK to start spamming out that beacon in the coffee shop. Meanwhile, over on their computer, they should see they'll keep scanning. And then after a few moments, hopefully the beacon will get received by their Wi-Fi. Hopefully in a few moments. Well, you're in a coffee shop. Go ahead and order yourself a coffee. Could take a little bit, kind of depends. We're still scanning. Oh, there it is. Cool. So over on your thing, you just keep sending beacons. But over here, we can see that we sent the message and it decoded to 555-2368. So someone in the coffee shop might see your SSID getting sent, but they won't know what the secret message is unless they happen to be running the script. So no ESP32s were harmed in the making of this film. However, I did try to put an ESP32 in backwards where the antenna was pointing in the wrong direction and it fits perfectly. But when you plug it in, it's not gonna work. So there you go. I obviously don't recommend you try this test, not on purpose, but it is kind of nice to know that you can power it up and at least for me, it didn't cause any harm. One other thing is make sure your Dolphin board is pushed all the way against the flipper. So in this case, I had the Dolphin board not pushed in all the way. And when you go ahead and power it up, obviously nothing is going to work either. Thanks for watching this overview of the ESP32. I'd appreciate it if you can take a moment to like and subscribe to the channel and drop me a comment letting me know what kind of videos you'd like to see more of.